check this out. Here we go. Here it is. What do you guys think of this right out here? Clap your hands. But the funny thing is, as embarrassing as I was, nobody ever made fun of my speech bubble. What they did make fun of me for was something I had no control over. My physical appearance and the way I look. Now some of you are like, come on dude, you don't look that bad. And I know half the teachers are like, call me. Ladies, I'm married, back off, right? Half are laughing, half are like, don't even go there, it's a Monday, all right? But seriously, what did they make fun of me for? If I can have your attention up here, everyone take a look. It wasn't my crooked nose or my silly hair, it was my ears. They thought my ears were too big. And if you look at this one real close, it's just shaped a little bit different. It's missing one of the bends, kind of funky up the top. You guys are all looking at my ear right now, aren't you?
Yeah.
Super awkward. Anyway, they nicknamed me ears, and honestly, that's how it started. Somebody making a silly joke about my ears. But one time the joke went too far. I'll never forget it. I'm riding my bike up at the dirt jumps. We had these awesome jumps. You start at this big dirt hill at the top, ride down, you go jump, jump, and a big jump at the end. So I'm at the top of the hill, getting ready to ride, and these tough guys show up. Now if I'm gonna fight these guys, I mean, come on, who do you think would win, me or them?
Them.
Not me, their arms were like, they were huge. I think they're on steroids in 8th grade. Anyway, they come up. They make some silly joke about my ears. It was something like, hey ears, what's up ears? What's your favorite movie, Dumbo? I was like, what? Since they were the cool kids, you know what everybody in the crowd did?
Laugh.
When they laughed, it encouraged them, so they pushed me. The crowd laughed even harder, so they pushed me even harder. Then one of them goes, hey, let's beat him up and take his bike. So they surround me, they start pushing me. I brace for the beat down. I needed somebody to save me. Somebody like Batman.
Yeah.
Pretty sweet, right? He could drop in there and be like, hey. Or maybe Spider-Man could save me. He could shoot some webs, wrap them up, and leave them hanging in a tree right next to a beehive. That'd be sweet. Or maybe, just maybe, a regular kid in the crowd would have the courage to speak up and go, hey, leave him alone. Just like that. A regular kid could have been like that. But the truth is, that day, those dirt jumps, nobody had the courage to speak up. Instead of standing up for me, everybody, they all just stood there. I've got good news and bad news. The good news, they didn't steal my bike. The bad news, somebody did speak up. Here's what they said. They go, hey, teach that punk a lesson. And with that, they pushed me down, fell from the top of the hill all the way to the bottom, and after that, it was pretty much over. I didn't even stand a chance. Did it hurt? Absolutely. But honestly, what hurt worse was looking up from the bottom and seeing everyone else towering over me, laughing, pointing their fingers. That's what hurt worse than breaking 6 bones. And the truth is, I'm not a student in school. I don't know a single person here But chances are sitting in these bleachers today, there just might be someone who knows exactly how it felt. Because you don't have to be pushed down from the top of the hill to know what it feels like to be different, to not fit in. I've shared my story at a lot of schools with over a million students. And after just about every show, someone will come up and share their story with me. But every once in a while, I'll hear a story from a student just like you that I'll never forget. It was a middle school just like this. These two girls came up after the show, asked me for autographs. They were so excited. They were like, oh my gosh, he's on the sound, I can't believe it! I was like, you need to chill, you're a stalker, okay? The one girl named Madeline points at a friend next to her and goes, she's my Batman. I was like, did you just say that? She's my Batman? I didn't know that would catch on. Batman's real name was Katie. To make a long story very short, Madeline was going through a tough time. Her mom had just died suddenly and unexpectedly. She didn't really have any friends at school. One day in gym class, the most popular girl in the school was saying some mean things, shoving her into the lockers. Time for somebody to step in and do something, right? The only problem was, all the other girls in the locker room, they wanted to be cool too. So 30 of them stood there and did nothing. All of them were too afraid to speak up. All of them, except for Katie. Katie did exactly what I'm asking you to do. She just said enough. And you know what it worked? Girls stopped, walked away. And afterward, Katie did the coolest thing. She went up to Madeline, put her arm around her, said, I'm gonna be your best friend, take care of you. I'm gonna be your new mom now. Her exact words. The two girls became best friends, Katie kept encouraging her. A few months later, Madeline tried out for America's Got Talent. She passed the first round of auditions, the judges loved her. What did Katie do? She brought her inner hero to the outside. Doesn't matter how strong you are, how popular you are, anyone can be a hero. It just takes some simple words and the courage to say them. Guys, your words are powerful, but many times in middle school, we forget just how powerful our words can be.
Here we go, this is it, last trick. Let's do it.